Welcome back, everyone, to Introduction to Theater, Chapter 4, Experiencing and Analyzing Plays. As we learned in previous lessons, an audience is one of the three essential ingredients for any theatrical event to occur. First, you must have an actor, someone who is creating a fictitious reality of time and space. Second, you must have a stage, a space for that actor to perform. And third, you must have an audience, a person or group of persons who bears witness to the fictitious reality that the actor is creating. If you were to only have an actor and a stage, then it would simply be a rehearsal. The presence of an audience is the magical difference between a rehearsal and a performance. This is an exciting topic for us at this point in the course because you're about to have your first chance to become an audience member at an actual live theater performance. You will no longer be a passive spectator who is just simply learning about theater, but you'll become one of the three things that are necessary for theater to even exist. It's an incredible experience to be part of an act of creation. There's a power to it that is almost mystical. And as such, that means that there is a special standard of behavior for theater audience members. It's different from crowds at movies and sporting events. This standard of audience etiquette is unique and will become a major topic in this chapter. Watch the videos below from the Theater Development Fund's Theater 101 series. This will give you an idea of what audience etiquette is like at professional commercial theaters on Broadway. And it will give life to some of the terms in Chapter 4. After you've watched the videos, click on the link titled Topics for Discussion. Then chime in on your class discussion board. This thread is titled R-Rated Theater, and yes, participation is graded. Good luck!